Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the David Ortiz Player Lock Farewell Tour series that we're doing here in MLB The Show 16. Having a lot of fun with this so far, controlling one of my favorite players in all of Major League Baseball, and this is a fun way to say farewell to Big Poppy as we continue to play through the first month of the season, taking on the Atlanta Braves here. We won two games in Atlanta, and now we shift back to Fenway Park for two more games, the home and home, if you will, in interleague play, sending Clay Buchholz to the mound today, and we'll see how he does. Well, he's got to improve on that 0-3 record and that 10.20 ERA. Not good at all. David Ortiz, however, red hot to start the season, 10 home runs, and Boston up 1-0. Already in the first, when Ortiz steps into the batter's box, 0-1 count, but he finds this pitch up in the zone and he hammers it to center field, deep and gone over the bullpen area there, as Ortiz is connected on his 11th home run of the season, and the Fenway crowd is loving it. 453 feet, my goodness, he absolutely blasted this one. Worthy of a replay, most definitely. We go to the wide angle here and zoom in on this baseball as it takes off. That one clears the Red Sox bullpen by a mile. Yeah, that's 453 feet worth right there. Red Sox continue on with that 2-0 lead in the fourth inning. 0-1 count to Ortiz, and he gets a hold of another one, but is it fair or foul? It is just foul. Oh, man, he knew he was that close to having number two in the game. Now with the 0-2 count, he is going to get that maybe off the end of the bat because it just flares into center field and drops for a hit. He's on. Well, for the second time in a row. He wasn't on base last time because he got to circle him with the home run, but there you go. He's entering this game as the Red Sox hit leader. Sixth inning at bat, and he just is going to hit a routine fly ball out to right field right there and is out for the first time in his three at-bats here at Fenway tonight. Let's go to his fourth at-bat. Eighth inning. 0-1 count, one out, and oh, he got that one. Deep and gone. I don't think it's as deep as the first one he hit, but it is his second home run of the game. Like I said before, when he hits them in bunches. Multiple home run games are his specialty, and he does it again here as he hits another one out of Fenway Park to right field, and the Red Sox looking good right here. That one only goes 425 feet. Still absolutely crushed. But yeah, it wasn't the 453-foot bomb he hit earlier. Nice, impressive pair of home runs, though, and a lot of distance accumulated with both. That one over the Braves bullpen. So he ends up being your player of the game with two home runs. And they were both solo home runs, but it's all that they need here to get the game in their favor. 5-1 win for Boston. They've won the first three of this home-and-home four-game set. Let's see if they can sweep it coming out here. And the Braves down on their luck. 6-15 to start this campaign out. The Red Sox under 500, but yeah, they're doing a little bit better than the Braves right now. Went with what I believe is a batting practice cap right there. Just trying to kind of mix things up once in a while. Probably wouldn't have seen that a whole lot just from Ortiz's at-bats because he's wearing a batting helmet, standard batting helmet there. But he's going to ground out to second base on that play. And he comes up in a 1-1 game in the fourth inning. Runner in scoring position, and I think he's going to bring him home here. This is in the gap. Now the question is, will he get two bases on this? He's chugging. Here he goes, the relay. Yeah, he's out. It's really hard to get a double with David Ortiz. Somebody said that my goal should be to hit a triple with him this year. And that's funny because I actually set up a community challenge. Was it last year or the year before? I forget when the community challenges started. To hit a triple with David Ortiz, and it was not an easy thing to do. This was lined down the right field line, but caught. Short corner down there, but it is able to be played by the right fielder, and the inning is over. We got a 2-2 game in the ninth, a chance to be a walk-off hero here with a base hit with just one out. Can he come through and get the Red Sox the victory? The pitch, and oh, that's a number down the line. Is it fair? They'll say fair ball. Freddie Freeman kind of crossed into foul territory, but he got the ball before doing so. Ortiz wants that swing back. He thought he could end this game, but instead, it's going to continue. You got the runner at third base. The Braves win it in 11 innings, 3-2, by pushing a run across. So the Red Sox squander an opportunity to sweep right there. But now, what we've all been waiting for, at least for the first time this season, we'll be taking on the New York Yankees. Yankees, Red Sox at Fenway Park. All right, the rivalry. Going to come down to a select number of clashes between the Red Sox and Yankees in this final season for David Ortiz. I'm sure he's going to relish these games against the Bronx Bombers. None bigger, of course, than the miracle comeback down 3-0 in the 2004 ALCS. Yeah, legendary stuff there. David Ortiz was able to be a part of. The Red Sox down 1-0 right now, when that is going to be played right into the shift there. Looks like, again, a ball that could go up the middle and be a base hit if you're playing everything straight up, but they don't play David Ortiz straight up ever. Always giving him that shift. Well, unless I guess you're playing for the double play, but this one is going to beat any shift you put on him. Hit to right center field, and can he get to second on this one? Yeah, he actually gets in there for the double this time. Nice. David Ortiz with the extra base hit, trying to get his Red Sox going here. As you see, a nice swing that's going to pull that into the gap. And a little bit of a slide there gets him in. Yeah, definitely not fleet of foot. He's not going to be mistaken for anyone resembling anything with speed. But 3-2 count to Mookie Betts, and Mookie Betts goes deep to left. It's a fair ball over the monster, and a two-run shot. There you go, Mookie. Thank you very much. As goodbye baseball indeed. 387 feet. And it gives the Red Sox a jump start here against the New York Yankees. Watch it again. Able to pull this one right down the line. Lofting shot. Extends Boston's lead to 4-1 now. And that is exactly what you want to do against the arch rivals. So it's 6-1 now in the fifth. Red Sox putting it on them right now. Ortiz back in the box with one out. Already chased the starter out of the game. And this pitch is going to be hit to center field and down for a hit. Nice job right there. He's got the double. And now a single as the Red Sox batting march continues here in this game. Let's see if they can tack on even more and bring Ortiz around to score. Well, we'll find out here in just a second. No, they don't. Nothing further comes across. It's still 6-1, and this one's going to be a ground out to first base. So he's got his two hits in this game, and it looks like the Red Sox are going to win the thing. That is exactly what ends up happening. So the Red Sox take game one in this 3-game set with the Yankees. You see the line score and all the particulars here. As we move on to game two now of three at Fenway Park, sending Rick Porcello out there. A check of the standings. The Red Sox have been playing better this week, but they still find themselves in last place by 4.5 games. They don't want to let that slip too far. They want to stay in contention. So Porcello going out to the mound to try to hold down the Yankees today. See if he can do just that. Yeah, he doesn't hold them down in the first inning. They get a run already. And the Red Sox down 1-0 when Ortiz comes to bat with two outs in the first. This pitch he finds, and he hits well to right field, but it hangs up there for the catch to be made, and the inning is over. Yankees lead 1-0 into the fourth still, and Ortiz smokes that one, but right at first base. Yeah, line shot right to Teixeira. He handles it, and he's out. 5-0 Yankees now in the sixth. Looks like this game's going the opposite of last night. That one's fielded on one hop by Teixeira and steps on the bag to get the out. Ortiz can't come up with anything. The Red Sox only have one hit as a team right now. Can't figure this one out. 2-2 count with two outs, and, well, making Teixeira work over there. They're kind of playing pepper back and forth, but Teixeira's gotten the best of this battle as he once again steps on the bag. It's going to be a 5-2 New York Yankees victory, so they even this at a game apiece, and now we flip the calendar into May and the final game of this 3-game set. Really liking how the light banks look here and how the light kind of reflects in the ballpark. It just looks a little refined this year. Maybe it's not, but it's certainly coming across that way. David Price starting to recover his poor start and get things going a little bit here in the last couple games. This ball, kind of interesting, hit right in that corner. And had that gone in the seats right there, it would have been a foul ball. But it stays in play, and David Ortiz is retired. 1-0 Yankees right now, and he gets under that. Oh, looking for that home run uppercut swing that paid off so well in game one of the series, but not here. He's going to fly out to shallow right field as the second baseman takes care of that. Still 1-0 in the sixth, having trouble scoring runs these last couple days. Again, grounds out to Teixeira, and it's not looking so good for the Red Sox bats anyway. They're still down 1-0 in the eighth. But they could break through. That one is going to get through the shift. There you go. Just barely. They almost had a play on it, but Ortiz is on. So now here's an interesting spot. Down 1-0. Do you pinch run for David Ortiz? Well, they decide yes, they're going to do that. They bring Jackie Bradley Jr. in the game. Now this is quite interesting. I didn't really know what would happen if you're doing the player lock and you get pinch run for. Well, the answer is you take over the entire ball club as if you were running franchise mode normally. So Mookie Betts hits a base hit to center field that does fall right in front of him. Had to decide whether to try to make a dive for that and possibly have it go behind him if he missed or play it conservatively. He chooses to play it conservatively. So now you've got Dustin Pedroia up with two outs. That's under the shortstop's glove. They're going to hold the runners. Base is loaded here. Don't want to get a guy thrown out at the plate in this spot. It wasn't a definite that he would score. As a matter of fact, I think he probably would have been out. Did they throw that to the plate? So Brock Holt up now. Base is loaded. Two outs. 1-2 count. He connects, and it's down for a hit in center field. One run's going to score. Here comes the go-ahead run, and the Red Sox rally for two here to take the lead. Time to get the closer up in the bullpen. Somebody alert Craig Kimbrell that he is going to be needed. Well, here he comes into the game. He's got six saves already in the season. That ERA, ouch. Yeah, let's not focus on that. Let's focus on the six saves. Trying to close this down. His very first pitch, and whoops. There goes the save. Didi Gregorius connects, taking that over the Red Sox bullpen. And just like that, we are tied at two. The very first delivery from Kimbrell in relief in the ninth to try to close it down, and it didn't take long for the Yankees to strike here. Jumping all over the first pitch he sees, Gregorius takes it deep for the solo shot, and we're going to have more baseball. You see the reaction there from Kimbrell, not a good one. He kind of doubles himself over here in disbelief. Well, we're going to play more baseball. Let's try to get out of this ninth inning and go try to win it in the bottom of the ninth. That's a strikeout. Got to throw down to first base. Come on, get it down there. Okay, inning is over. So after surrendering the solo homer, Kimbrell gets out of the inning. Here we go now in the ninth. That is going to be down the line, and fair ball. Kicks around. It does not go over the wall. No ground rule double. Is he going to try for third? No. 50 speed. We'll just play it safe and stay right there. But you do have the potential winning run at second base now. And the Red Sox in a good position to try to win this game. Watch a replay of this swing. Taking it right down the line. And it's going to kick around that corner. They're ensuring that he gets extra bases. Now, can the Red Sox finish this off? Let's find out here. Your next batter. Oh, this is interesting. This is kind of cool. New screen right here. Instead of just a notification popping up, you actually get a split screen shot of the dugout and your runner there if you want to replace him. I choose not to because I don't have any more speed really than what was there on the bases. Travis Shaw comes through with a hit again. Yeah, because you don't have a speedster to bring in there. Jackie Bradley Jr. was already brought in the game earlier for David Ortiz, but you do have that base hit, and now with nobody out, you got Xander Bogaerts coming in, and all he's got to do is get this ball up in the air, get a sac fly, and we can go home. And now that's what he does, drives it to center field. This should be ball game. It is going to be caught out there, but tagging up to score, and the Red Sox win the game. Funny how baseball is. Kimbrell comes in, blows a save, but he's going to get credit for the win here in the Red Sox walk-off victory. There you go. Xander Bogaerts does his job, gets that ball lifted in the air. Catching this ball in the outfield really is kind of a moot point. Like, I mean, catch it if you want. Otherwise, just let it go because there's no way you're throwing him out from that distance. And that is your ball game. The Red Sox win. And we're talking about cool new animations. Check this one out. I heard about this, but you got the post-game Gatorade bath to Dustin Pedroia. I love it. I love that they added that in. That is sweet. Now, can we get like the shaving cream pie to the face? Do they have that one too? I kind of doubt it, but if it's in,
I will certainly be featuring that when I see it. Anyway, Boston wins 3-2. They win the series 2-1. And all is good, at least for tonight in Boston, as you got to take out the rivals. We are 12-14, though, as we reset for the next episode, taking on the White Sox. And then, oh, yeah, to Yankee Stadium for 3 games. Should be fun. We'll see you next time for more David Ortiz Farewell Tour.
Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.